Hello, it's me again.
Hello, it's me again. I got these babies finished. I'm going to go ahead and do the first coat of varnish. Sorry, I didn't paint online. I know I promised, but I just didn't feel like it. So, I'm going to show you how this is my big thing of golden varnish. It's polymer matte varnish with UV protection. So, it has sun protection. Sun protection! So, I'm going to show you just how I mix up my golden varnish. They're still out of the soft touch varnish everywhere. I'm hoping they get some in soon. I hope they didn't just stop making it entirely. I'm going to have to get a new big bottle of varnish soon. I'm almost out. Oh, come on you. I had to get my husband to open this because it was all glued. I should probably wipe off the top of it. Do that after. So where's my... Oh, shoot. I didn't get that out. I thought I was prepared. What did I get for thinking? Okay. Super matte. I just put a little bit in here. I used to put a lot more, but I only just put like... Are you going to come out? Hold on. Gotta mix this up because it's not pouring. I need to put more popsicle sticks in here. Oh, I don't have much left actually. I'm just going to take like this much. This is like 3/4 full. I basically just mix it up until it, because this varnish is usually kind of a clear kind of yellow color. Yellowish, clearish. Yeah, that's it. So it turns a little bit white. See? Dripping all over the place. I think I'm going to put a tiny, tiny bit more in. See if I can grab a little tiny bit more. There we go. Okay, boom. That's enough. I need more of this too. I got lots of stuff that I don't need. I need to replenish my stock here. So I always do the golden first. There, that looks better. Kind of looks like a little bit milky. Okay. Now if anybody sees any of the Americana Soft Touch anywhere, please let me know. Because they have the ultra matte, but it's not as matte as this is. I mean, I put some matting powder. I use McPherson's matting powder. Here we go. I use this, and a lot of people use cornstarch and diatomaceous earth mixed together, or just cornstarch, or just the earth. But I just buy this because it's easier for me. I don't have to mess around with anything. Easy. I like easy. What is that noise? My chair's making weird noises. Okay. So first of all, I want to brush these off just in case there's any little fuzzies or hairs or anything. And she looks really red, but when you put the varnish on, it kind of tones it down a little bit. I also don't like it. I got her arms and legs too. Almost match. They're very close as you look at the top of the head because the face is lighter. So you always look at the top of the head because that's where the true color is going to be. So hopefully when we varnish, they'll look okay. I sometimes will add a little bit after the first coat of varnish, like add some powders or whatever, just to check to make sure that, you know, just to, because it's hard sometimes to gauge what they're going to look like. Pre-varnish, post-varnish, what they're going to look like post-varnish. Okay, so, oh, I wanted to thank everyone for giving the well wishes for my my grandson. He's at home now, and he's happy, doing good, and I'm doing better, just getting ready for my my surgery. I'm trying to finish up rooting. I'm rooting my custom Maggie. And I'm sorry I haven't listed all the babies I promised I was going to list. But I'm slow. I also want to take some more pictures of Nino. I'm going to have my husband help me clean up. I feel bad. I'm embarrassed. Move into my new studio and it's already a mess. As you can see. Sorry. I got to clean up. I need help though. So my husband's home today. Sunday. Have him help me clean up. Because yesterday was shopping day. Okay. And here is little Santa. Little boy. I tried to hide. There's wrinkles in between the forehead right here. And they don't look good. They don't look natural. So I tried to hide them as best I could. When I put the varnish on, it'll hide them even more. The problem with, like, when you use air dry paints, it's the only problem is, well, for me, the main problem is that you have to let them sit for at least 2 weeks to make sure the varnish is cured. Because if you don't wait for the varnish to cure, if you try to root, it'll make little marks all over the head. Even though they're underneath the hair, you can, if you have really thin hair like I'm going to do on him, it'll be really, really noticeable. You want to make sure that you let them sit for, I mean, at least a week. I do 2 weeks. Because I want to make sure the varnish is nice and cured. Legs to do here. So I gave him a more like more pale skin tone than Kimmy has. Speaking of pale, I can't wait to do another albino. I gotta find a kit that I really want to use though. I don't know if I told you guys this, but I have to repaint again Madeline because I messed her up again. Like I said, she's my problem child, but I will keep trying. I have a new idea for her, so hopefully that'll work. All right. So I got a couple of these brushes. I need one kind of dense brush. This is good. And I need a fluffy brush. I'm going to get a couple extras to have just in case I need them. These two are dense brushes. And a fluffy brush. I need to get some more smaller brushes. I'm running out. Okay, let's do, here, we'll do this arm first. I'm going to put the end of this on here so I can hold it better. Because I had to cut these a little bit, remember, told you that because there was tiny little holes and there's no way I'm going to be able to get glass beads in there. So I'm just going to brush this on here. I'm going to just do the arm first, the little arm part first. And I'm going to use a nice clean squishy sponge. Pounce that in. Just get like the kind of the wet part off, and then I'm going to pounce with the dense brush first. And the fluffy brush. I'm gonna use a little brush to get inside the little creases. I would like to just, like, find another varnish to use since this Americana is, I don't understand. They have all their other varnish. Maybe it's because so many people in the doll community use it. I don't know. But I can't find it anywhere. There we go. That looks nice. I just wonder if I can't get away sometimes with just using this varnish, but sometimes it I don't know, it looks too matte, but then, you know, when you let it sit, it gets shiny again, so. I just like the soft touch just, I don't know, makes them look alive, makes them pop. It's got like a kind of a mix between dewy and matte. Okay. Dense brush. Here, I'm going to zoom you guys in so you can see better. There we go. Can see a little bit better. The light's not very good, sorry. It's early, but I wanted to get a video out for you guys today. Because I've been so lazy lately. Actually, I haven't been lazy. I've been working. I'm trying to get Maggie done for her mommy. I want to get her shipped out before I have to go to the hospital. Okay. Here's the little giveaway fisty. Okay. So we're going to put... Pull her back off of the shutter. It's stuck on there. There we go. Okay. Now let's do this hand, and then we'll do her head, and then we'll do her feet. Okay. So again, I'm just going to do the arm part. And you can see there's some pink on there. That's, I did like do like a quick dusting over the arms because the arms just look too, they needed more red. So, and I didn't want to do a whole wash, so I just kind of dusted over them with the powders to give them a little bit of a red tint. And I know that, you know, a lot of it's going to come off, but it still looks nicer. So I kind of rub it in with a sponge, a more dense sponge, like this dirty thing. You can see I've been using it. It's well used. Okay, now we can do the hand. I like this hand. It's a lot of detail. And it's such a tiny little hand. I love doing minis, like with like a lot of detail. It's kind of difficult actually, especially when you're blind because you're old like me. But it's a. More of a challenge, more fun that way. I like to be challenged. Give me a challenge, I shall overcome. Okay. So much fun to just watch me. Am I out of frame? Probably. Because I'm looking at what I'm doing. Sorry. You want to get like up inside, you know, all the little crevices because you don't want a bunch of varnish sitting inside your creases. That doesn't look very nice. I had to learn all this stuff the hard way. Kitty story. So, you know, I have like 6 cats now because I told you we got another one that was running loose outside. My husband was coming home the other day and he came down the driveway and there's little kittens in there. So we of course brought her in, but like I can't have another kitten. Just do the back of the head first. And we're gonna pounce. So luckily my aide, my newer aide that takes care of me during the day and, you know, does the housework and the laundry and all that great stuff. She wanted her. So I'm like, oh, you can have her. Go ahead. Yay. So I was going to put her up for adoption. But I'm glad, because it's hard when you have other cats. You have to keep the new cat separate until you can get him to the vet to have him tested for feline leukemia and everything. So it's hard because my kids end up having to do it, because I can't put him in my room because of my dog wants to be with me all the time. So I can't lock her out. She would freak. She's also smart. She'd know it was because of a cat. And then she would not be happy. She already tries to herd the cats. She's a border collie, so she tries to herd the cats around. She thinks she's like the designated mom or something. Like whenever I say, you know, like, get down or something like that to one of my cats, she comes running. Like, what? I'll do it. I'll get him down. She's my best friend. So are my kitties. I love my animals. But, you know, enough. Got enough kitties right now. Can't afford to do all the vet stuff and just, you know, run out of room. I have to keep them out of here because I don't want kitty fur on my babies. I feel bad locking my dog out. She wants to be in with me, but too much hair. And right now it's shedding season, you know. All you people with animals know. Shedding season. They are shedding all over the place. It's like I have to clean my chair. My white cat, one of my white cats, I have two, sleeps on my chair at night. So every morning I have to use the roller to clean it all off, because it's all full of white hair. I usually put a towel or a blanket down for her, but I forgot. Sometimes I have forgotten. Okay, so I do the back first, then the side, and then I'll do the other side. And then we do the top and the front. That's just how I do it. It helps if you do it in sections, so whichever sections you want to do, that works. Pouncy pouncer. And I have been trying to get away from my powders more since Coastal Scents went out of business, even though I know that there's another place that I can get powders from. I think that the veins and the capillaries and stuff look more realistic when they're done with paint. So I'm back to painting my veins and my capillaries. I use a really, really thin brush, like a hair to paint hair brush, you know, really, really thin, like barely, there's only a couple bristles on it. I use that to do the capillaries, and I also have started painting eyebrows, so it's also a new thing for me, because I think that looks better too than the pencils. I used to use the Prisma pencils. I still use Prisma pencils on the nail tips because I think that looks more realistic than slapping paint on there. But I bought some thick medium. It's what's that stuff called? They've gone out of business since. Here, let me pounce this ear first before I look for the name. But some stores still sell some of their stuff. I really love their dry skin medium. And I bought a bunch of that before it was all gone. I never used the paints, but I like their mediums. But I think the people that were making this brand of paints, and yes, this is a mess too. Here it is. It's, what's it called? Miracle Blend, yeah. So a Miracle Blend, I bought from the Italian store. They have some of the thick medium left. So, I'm going to maybe use that and mix it with the paint and see if I can do some nail tips, because I know people with Genesis, that's what they use. You like mix it with thick medium. So we will give that a shot and see how that comes out. We got the sides of the head, we got the top of the head. Pounce this a bit more. Look around for shiny spots. There we go. Okay, so we just need to do the top now, or the front of the face. I had some problems with her mouth. I ended up cutting that side over there a little bit because it's like one side's open and the other side, it had that little piece of like webbing stuck in there. So I just cut that out a little bit. Always scary using an X-Acto knife on a baby. Even when you cut the eyes open, it's scary. You cut the backs of the eyes. Always scary. I'm gonna slip and go through the face. Especially on my sold out kits, my Natalie Blick babies, and I go really slow. Very careful. Very, very careful. Okay. That looks good. I like it. I like it. Okay. All right. I think we got her. Sorry, I'm looking. I'm gonna hold her over here. I don't know if you guys can you guys see her veins or anything? I don't know if you can see her or not. I'll have to look back on the playback. I can't see very well with the ring light on. But she looks good. I need to, when I put I actually use Pledge, like floor wax. On the eyes and stuff, the commonly used thing. It makes the plastic eyes, these are Ico eyes. It makes these look more like glass eyes, but I use it on my glass eyes too, but I also use it on the lips and, the fingernails. But, once I do that, her lips won't look so dark. They came out darker than I wanted them to, but that was because I was kind of trying to hide that space. But yeah, I'll do more touch-ups afterwards, but she looks pretty good. Let's see with her with the arm, since it's already varnished. Now she looks darker than the arm does. I'll probably have to put a I don't know. What do you guys think? I think it looks pretty comparable. So the top of the head looks a little bit darker now than the... I might do another... I don't know. We'll see how it looks with the... Okay, this one's getting... See how this is getting gunky? I'm going to switch to... my second set of brushes here. So I'm going to use this dense brush. I'm going to take a drink. Spicy. How's your guys' weather? My weather is really pretty during the day, but it gets cold at night. So I couldn't stand leaving that poor little kitten outside. There's no way. I think I'm going to need another one of these too. This one's getting kind of gunky. Because if you let your brush get gunky, it'll start like depositing little white pieces of dried varnish on your baby, and you don't want that. That's not a good thing. Okay. I'm going to be boring, and I'm going to varnish the other baby, or at least part of it. Let's kill my battery. That'll be fun. I'll probably edit this a little bit, so it's not so tedious for you guys to watch if you want to watch it. And that was cute. I did kill that little footy, even though it's big. She's got nice little nails. I like Adrie, I think Stoet. Stoet? No, Stoet. Stoet. I have to figure out how to pronounce her name. It looks like Stoet, but I know, maybe it is Stoet because it's Germanic, I think. Okay. I like her babies. And, I did, I had a Joy head that I bought off a site, and, it's a, one of her kits. And I did a cuddle baby a long time ago, a couple years ago, and I really loved painting her, and I keep thinking, I want to get the whole kit, and I just never get around to doing it, because I'm always buying all these other babies. And sometimes I think, maybe I should just stick to big babies, because I think I'm a little bit better with bigger babies, but I think my problem with smaller babies is I just don't stop soon enough. I keep painting, you know, beyond what I need to, and then they end up being a little dark. Like, not dark as in, like brown skin or anything. Like, dark as in, like, kind of muddy. So it doesn't look natural. It doesn't look like a skin tone that would exist. Looks kind of ashen. And then I end up not liking them and stripping them. And that's a hard process. But I think I just need to slow down. And I mean, toddlers are easy for me. Except for that one. I think I like the idea of her being like a darker skin baby, like a I actually wanted her to be a baby like from Mongolia, a Mongolian baby. But she's so hard to paint. I don't know where I got the crazy idea to paint her, you know, brown basically, because it's hard. I have so much respect for people that paint darker skin babies, AA babies, ethnic babies, whatever you want to call them. I think, it's hard because you mess up that brown, it streaks. If you get a streak or something, you're done. You can't fix it. With like white Caucasian babies, you can fill in a little problem sometimes, but you don't get it right the first time, especially air dry. It's so hard. My Tootie came out good. I'm happy with her. I had a couple little problems with my Ava, but she still turned out really nice too. Just had to give her a little birthmark because I didn't want to have to strip her arms and legs and do it over again. I was tempted, but I'm not doing it. I gotta stop. I need to stop stripping babies. I need to just, I try to match up my hand with their hand sort of, and their skin tone. Okay, I'm doing the bottom half, the arm part, the forearm, and I'm gonna do the forearm. The upper arm. I'm doing that first, and then I'm going to do the forearm in the hand all at the same time because she's so small. If I was doing like a toddler, I would just do, you know, one part of the arm, next part of the arm, and then the hand. Because by the time you get to the rest of the arm, it's going to be partially dry. And you won't be able to mat it as well. Also, you won't be able to get it out of the little crevices. Little, you know. The little creases. Her creases do not want to hold paint or powder. So I had to go over and over and over. And the, like, kind of... set it in with the paint. Some people will set their powders with a like a sealer, but I just go over it with paint, and that seals it. Because if you rub it in with the sponge, not only do you get rid of the excess that you don't really want there, but you you kind of set it in, kind of rub it into the vinyl. But yeah, this vinyl is not not happy about holding on to the paint or the powders, but I got him. He looks nice. I think I like his skin tone. There's his hand. So this is just fresh varnish. It'll look a little bit different when it dries. It gets a little more matte, and you can almost hear it. Kind of like fine grade sandpaper, which is why I don't usually use this. It's like some babies, like her, she feels. See, this is soft, but on this vinyl, it's kind of rough, and so that's another reason why I go over it with the soft touch, because I don't want that, you know, that sandpapery feel on the outside of my babies. Sometimes if I don't use the sponge, it'll be softer too. And I think it's like habit now to be able to do it this way, because I like that grit so I can do the eyebrows and the nail tips. But since I'm not doing the eyebrows with the pencils anymore, I really don't need that. That slight grit to it, but it does help on the nail tip still. They look nicer if there's something for them, the pencils, to grab onto. I'm gonna get a new smaller brush because that one's all gunky. I know a little while ago someone asked me how to wash the brushes. I get the bars of brush cleaner, and I just I get hot water and I rinse as much as I can of the varnish off, and then I put the soap on it, and then I, you know, brush it up against my hand. I also have a little a little thing to actually wash these kind of brushes, makeup brushes, little bumpy thing to rub it on. So I use that. And then I rinse it with hot water, rinse all the soap out of it, and then they're nice and clean. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do the head, and then I'm gonna do the legs off camera, and I can show you guys how they look after I'm completely done on the next video. I have some kits that are coming in the mail, so I can show those off. Some I'm excited about. So that will be fun. Open that on. Not as tedious as watching me varnish. Basically, with the nail tips, I just take my white Prisma pencil and I draw on the nail tips, and I kind of will buff it off so they don't look white. They don't look really strong. They look natural because little babies don't really have really, you know, strong whites on their nails like, you know, like we do. I bite my nails, so sorry about that. How gross. Yeah, I know. Okay, here we go. Got a little wet spot right here. You gotta watch for that. Okay, we're gonna do this. I'm gonna do a little Mr. Cutie's head right here. And this is, of course, a Ping Lao kit. Sensa. And I love Ping Lao. Most of her kits I'm dying to get, like, most of her, some of them I'm not real thrilled about, but a lot of her new, toddlers, some of them I already have, I'm anxious to get to, but, I need to slow down a little bit, get these other babies rooted and get them out for sale. I just like painting, and I know I should try to paint hair more often, but I really like rooting too. I like the way my babies look with rooted hair. This one's gonna have nice light hair, thin hair, like baby hair, baby fine hair. Side here. Oop. He's cute. His mommy Annette from Aunt May's lovely place. She wants him to look more like sort of like her grandson and her son. How her son looked when he was little. Oops, wrong one. This one. I can show you how his face looks before I finally end this long video. Like I said, I'll probably edit some of this out so it won't be so tedious. Other side. I need a drink. Throat. Okay. Almost done. And it's time to change the sponge too. I like the way he looks with the varnish. Looks really nice. Yay. I'm always worried. It's like, are they going to look good after the varnish? I like the way he looks. Sorry, keep holding him out of frame again. Well, maybe he's in frame. Yeah, we're in frame. Because I pulled it out a little bit. I zoomed out. Still not sure about the eyes yet. I'll have to maybe try it. It's so hard to get eyes in his head. Got that hard head and the opening is so small, but it's the way it is, you know. Sometimes you gotta deal with more, that all kits are different. Like I always say, you never know like how one's gonna respond. Sometimes they all respond differently to paints, they'll respond differently to, you know, the eyes. I've had kids that say, you know, the eyes are this size and they're not. They're actually either bigger or smaller. It's like they all have their own little personalities. Okay, so we got the top, the sides, the back done. Let's do the front. I was looking at lights for painting, but I think I'm going to take those little lights and put them over here. I think that would help you guys to see better. Change my brushes. They're not being very helpful right now. His mouth still looks a little pinky. I think I kind of like it. I kind of like it. Get your little cheekies. Might put a little more blush on him too, because, like I said, some of it just comes, or the varnish tones it down, the reds. So I usually will make my babies more red than they need to be. Actually, that looks good. I like it almost looks kind of blotchy. See, this is why I like this vinyl, because it's like, I don't know. I just like the way it takes paint, and even though it's hard sometimes to get it to take paint and the powders, I like the way it looks. It looks, like I said, it looks like almost like little normal blotchy skin. Might do a little tiny bit more blush on him, but I'm sorry, he looked kind of weird without eyes, I know, but he looks really cute. And his lower lip is a little pink, a little more pinky than I wanted it to be. I might darken that a tiny bit, or I might not. I'll have to think about it. Kind of like the way it looks, though. Kind of makes I'm gonna pounce this a little bit more. Kind of makes the inside of his mouth look nicer. Okay, so I'm gonna let you guys go. So, if you like what I'm doing, please like and subscribe. If you don't. and go get some paint and a doll kit and paint with me when I do paint. I mean, do have a lot of videos that show how to paint. So I will do more too, I promise. Okay, so I'll talk to you guys later. Okay, bye.